you how many Chinese nationals were working in Lucky South 99?
Karen, hindi bababa ng 1,000 ang nagtatrabaho doon. Kaya nga when we
Chinese nationals
Chinese, Malaysians, Vietnamese, mixed po ito, halo-halo. So less less than 1,000. What, come again, ma'am?
Nasaan na po sila, sir, itong mga foreigner?
Yun ang nakakalungkot na bahagi ng aming trabaho. Hindi may tatatwa that our operation was compromised. And this was not the first time that the PAOK's operation against this particular Togo Hub, some farms have been compromised, no? So it's quite obvious that someone, somewhere in the long chain of government or long chain of applying for the search warrant or whatever, someone within our ranks, among us, leaked this particular information. Kaya nga po kami ay masusi nag-iimbestiga, and we've called on the different member agencies who participated in this operation to subject all its members to an investigation, beginning with myself, because together with the legal officer, we were the ones who developed this particular case operation. No? So we arrived there June 4. The entire building was dark. The complex was closed. No one was inside the facility anymore. People were outside the facility. So all that we could do is simply exercise what is known as a welfare check in search for the possible victims that we were trying to rescue. So that's the bottom line. So where they are, I could hazard a guess by saying that they've simply relocated to other scum farms scattered all over Central Luzon and in Metro Manila.
All right. So we don't have enough time now, but I do hope to have you back on Head Start next week, because this is an ongoing investigation. And I know that you're not yet finished, right? In checking Porak, I think you have 10 buildings to go. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Uh-oh. So sana po, sir, on Monday, I can have you again so we can have a thorough discussion about this. But anything you'd like to add today? Because We have another guest this morning, but this is very important, really, just for us to really push through with this discussion. What are your plans today?
What are my plans today? Basically, to be able to go to Porak and make sure that everything is above board and we're able to meet our timeline to conclude our search no later than Sunday. By Sunday, we mean to say we'd have to apply for an extension of our warrant. Probably by tomorrow, because we only have 10 days. Now, second is I'd like to call our agency, our commission, our chairman, the executive secretary, and our executive director, Undersecretary Gilbert Cruz. We would like to call on all local chief executives. Please help us in the fight against scum farms. Please, motu proprio, don't wait for the national government to go and raid and disrupt these scum farms. Motu proprio, act on your own. They're scattered all over Central Luzon. I hate to name the municipalities because I don't want to put the local chief executives in a very bad light. But please, they're all over Central Luzon. They're all over Metro Manila. They're all over Calabarzon. They're even in Cebu province. They're even in Palawan. Whew, they're scattered all over. Simply act on your own, motu proprio, and help the national government rid us of this problem. Thank you, Karen.
Thank you. On that note, thank you so much, Mr. Winston Casho, for joining me today. Thank you.